If you guys need help gearing up for any of the new content in Red Dead Online, GTA Online, or just looking for some new games, check out G2A with the link in the description, and use cashback code BOSS if you want to save a little bit extra as well. Hey, how's it going, guys? Mr. Boss for the win here, and in today's Red Dead Redemption 2 video, we are going to be going inside of the Hermit Devil's Cave, but this time we're going to be turning all the lights off. Because I've been told something pretty spooky actually happens, or something pretty scary is revealed. So in case you guys have never been to the Devil's Cave, it's actually located on the far west-hand side of the map. It's kind of hard to explain literally what it's next to, but when I say it's on the border of the map, it really is there. The closest thing to it is like Hanging Dog Ranch. If you find that, you're pretty close to where this location actually is. So if you've never been to this spot for the first time, it's literally a cave that's outside of the map. The second you go inside, your mini map will actually shift to a different look where you can sort of see the layout of the entirety of the cave. And you can tell just how dark it is in here, and there isn't much going on. There's a couple of lanterns that keep the entire place lit, which will actually turn off as we get going. And if you've never met the Cave Devil, I'll give you guys an idea right now of who he is, what he sounds like, and the interaction that Arthur actually has with him. Take a listen to this.
Go away, please. Why don't you turn around and go back to the light? Can you leave my cave, please? Go and find your own cave. There are nasty things and nasty people down here, and I don't mean you. I'm the devil. I'm the devil. I'm the devil! Okay, I'm not the devil. But I want to be. I want to be. And that's even worse. I'm a nasty man. Go away. I don't want you here. Is that so bad? Wanting solitude? Wanting loneliness? Wanting anything but you? Go away.
So you're the genius we've all been waiting for.
My God, you're a fool. Goodbye.
So you guys can actually have 5 encounters with the Cave Devil, but he actually will never come down from his little spot, his like perch up there. However, you can actually get up to him. There's one of these like rocks that you can jump on, and if you do that, you'll able to sort of launch yourself up there. And we've checked out this spot before, but I've always had the lantern on and I've always kept all the lights on. Well, apparently if you turn off the lights, something interesting is revealed. So let's try that right now. Let's take our lantern away and see if we can find anything. And the first thing I noticed is that the markings or paintings on the wall seem to be much more defined. So I don't really know what they are. In the middle there, you can kind of see some stick figures and then some bigger paintings. However, I don't think it's quite dark enough. So what I wanted to do after that was actually shoot at the lantern. I wanted to get rid of more of the light there. And then I wanted to shoot out all the candles. Now it's for the most part pitch black, aside from that like glowing lava pit on the floor. And yes, with the lights off, you can now see the wall paintings a whole lot better. It's almost as if this is like an 1899 version of a black light, like where you can only see the writing under certain lighting conditions. That's pretty cool. So trying to make out what these characters are, they're kind of like enhanced stick figures. And I don't know if this was drawn by the Cave Devil or by someone else. It's clear that he's the only one who lives here, But there's a good chance that someone else might have been here before that. And you can see these giant markings all throughout the cave. The bigger versions seem to be drawn in red. It might be blood, it might be something else, with both their arms in the air and what looks to be their mouth wide open. Again, what that's supposed to be, I don't know, but it's pretty spooky. There's also a couple of animals drawn as well, and you guys can kind of see the difference here. When you turn on the light, they almost do turn invisible, like they sort of blend in with the wall. The second you turn off the light, they become much more visible, much more pronounced. So that is incredibly unique right there, and I wonder what these symbols actually mean. Now, as always, if you guys feel like you have a better idea of what's going on here, let us know in the comments down below, or you can reach out to me on my Facebook page if, once again, you feel like you have a better idea of what these symbols are, or maybe something I missed throughout the video. Now, that's only one spot in the Cave Devil's hideout. I wanted to try some of the other locations in the cave as well. So what I did is I started going around putting out all of the lanterns. There's actually a handful of them located throughout this cave. So I started knocking out all the different lanterns and I was making my way towards the bridge when I noticed something incredibly creepy. Now, I'm convinced that this bridge here, this wooden suspended bridge, is haunted. Look how much it's moving. Like, we're not stepping on it. There's no wind in here. It's a cave, so it's not like anything would be causing it to move. Why is this bridge moving up and down like there's a giant creature going back and forth? All I know is that is incredibly spooky. I don't even want to know why, but something is definitely haunted in here. Whether it's a ghost, spirit, I don't know, but something definitely spooky is going on inside of this cave. Now, I ended up putting out the final light, and that might have been a mistake because it ended up catching the entire bridge on fire. At first, I thought I was going to be trapped in here, like the bridge would get ignited, and it would just not be able to be used after that. But unfortunately, at least some of it was fireproof. So the whole bridge ended up not catching on fire, but it's still so creepy. And then I even stepped on the bridge, and look at this thing jumping up and down. Like, I feel like I'm on a ride at an amusement park. This thing is going up and down like crazy. So something is going on here, and I'm a little bit scared to find out. However, let's get back to the main point here. We've turned off all the lights in this cave, and now I want to find out what's going on in here. So in that original tunnel we were going through, with all the lights off, you can see these sort of like glowing handprints on the wall. I don't know if they're supposed to be handprints or in the shape of handprints, but if you turn the lights on, you can sort of see how they're supposed to look as well. But when you turn them off, they sort of glow. And I think this is so cool. There's sort of like a darker red set of these handprints, and then there is a lighter pink version of the handprints. I'm not sure what the difference is supposed to be here, but again, there's something spooky and crazy going on here, and there's a lot of things that are revealed when the lights go off. Now, I wanted to go back up to the Devil's Cave because I wasn't satisfied with that like glowing lava pit that we found. And I was thinking to myself, how can I get rid of that light? I mean, you can shoot at it and it doesn't do anything. You know, there's no real object to throw over it. So I figured we needed a sacrifice, and for that, we are going to be using the Cave Devil. So what I did here is I ended up punching the Cave Devil, which, as you guys know, he has like the lowest health in the game. Like, literally, you could flick him, and he would die. But this gave me the opportunity to pick up his body, and I wanted to use it as a shield or a cover for the light. Now, after a few tries, I was able to successfully get his body on top of it, and now we are in complete darkness up here. How cool is that? So if you guys would like to try this for yourself, this is something that you can do. You can use the Cave Hermit's body as a way to keep the light away. So after doing that, it was cool to look at the wall again, but I didn't notice anything different or unique. And then I thought to myself, wait a minute, what if I used Arthur's like eagle eye, eagle vision? Would it reveal something different? And aside from the Cave Devil or Hermit like glowing on the fire pit, it didn't really reveal all that much. But it still did give us a pretty good look at the drawings on the inside of the cave. So just like those alien paintings that we looked at the other day, I think these mean something, and I think there's something pretty significant going on here, but I just can't put my finger on what it might be. Are these drawings connected to the cave devil? Are they related to something else? Were they drawn by someone else? That is a big question, and I'd love to get your guys' help trying to figure it out. So if you feel like you have a better idea of what's going on here when we turn off the lights in the cave devil's hideout, let me know in the comments down below. I'd love to hear from you guys down there. If you did go on to enjoy this video, though, a like rating would, of course, be awesome. And subscribe to my YouTube channel if you are new, or you like daily Red Dead Redemption 2 videos like this. With all the way, guys, like I said, thanks so much for watching. Take care, and I'll see you guys in the next video.